Hey guys, it's Elisa here and welcome back to the Sewing Time vlog. Today is a super special one because I would love to chat with you about my proudest sewing make up to this date. And that's my wedding dress. So I would love to share with you where did I get my inspiration to make my own wedding dress. You know, where did I get the pattern, the fabric, what kind of anxiety I went through. It's definitely a lot of joy to make something so special for yourself and, you know, the memory of which you will carry through the lifetime. So you guys know the drill. You let me know in the comments below what is your favorite and proudest sewing make up to this date. You know that I read all the comments and respond, and I'm always looking forward to seeing what you guys have to say. Grab yourself that favorite hot beverage. I'm drinking raspberry zinger today because it's super gloomy outside here in Tennessee. It's been raining for like a week, and I just really need something summery and refreshing. And let's dive right into it. So I have mentioned once before in one of my videos that I've made my own wedding dress, and today I just really wanted to dig deeper in the whole process. And before we start talking about wedding dress itself, I wanted to let you know that whether it is a wedding dress, or maybe it's your first time working with leather, or is the first time making a suit jacket, or first time working with interfacing, whatever is your next big thing in sewing, you have to believe in yourself. Everything starts with that true belief in your own abilities, in your own skill set. Because although my sewing skills were at quite medium level at the point of making this wedding dress about 5 years ago, the belief in my own abilities, that's, I think, what carried me through and what made this wedding dress possible. Because if I wouldn't believe that I can actually do it, I think this probably would be still in a UFO pile. And I would probably end up going and buying my wedding dress off the rack somewhere in the bridal salon. So whatever it is that you are attempting next, whatever is your proudest sewing make on your sewing table, you have to believe in yourself. As for the reason why I decided to make my own wedding dress, looking back, I don't think I can find one big solid reason why, because it really wasn't that big of a money question, although it did save a lot of money, a ton really. And it really wasn't a big question about not finding what I like, because at that point we used to live in Las Vegas, and as you know, it's the city of weddings, and you can find any sort of bridal wear that you can only imagine on this planet. Seriously, you can find anything in Vegas. So it wasn't really about that. I think the biggest point of me making my own wedding dress was that I wanted to prove to my family and my friends and my loved ones that I can sew. I can sew, and it's not just about, you know, mending clothing or restyling clothing. I can really create something almost couture-like. I can create a gown for the biggest day of my life, because although my family and loved ones and friends, they love me very much and they respect me in many, many ways in my life, I think the sewing part always kind of came to them almost like a joke, if that makes sense. I'm not sure. Let me know if you feel the same way. Every time I would say something like, yeah, you know, I'm sewing this or I'm sewing that, I don't think it really clicked with them or to them that, yeah, I can make clothing and I can replicate designer stuff, and that's a really valuable skill. So I think that was the turning point for me when I decided, you know what, I'm just gonna make my own wedding dress. And because I did feel like my loved ones and friends and family kind of took it as a joke, I kept the fact that I'm making my own wedding dress in secret up until probably maybe like a couple of weeks before the wedding itself, because I just really felt uncomfortable. And I knew that in order for me to believe in myself and my own abilities, I needed to have zero distractions, you know, in order to complete this task. So I didn't want anybody to call me up and say, hey, are you sure about making your own wedding dress? Are you sure you can do it? So I really wanted to have that really clear mind and really clear focus of, you know what, I'm doing this, and whatever anybody says, I am wearing my own handmade wedding dress and walking down that aisle. You won't believe it, but a good petticoat is going to change your life. So when I first made the wedding dress, you know, it had this huge long train, and I put it on myself. I was alone in our apartment, so I made sure that my husband was away. And I'm standing there in the bathroom, and this dress is just like a little floppy on me. And I'm thinking, oh my God, what have I done? Like, in my mind, I was thinking about this gorgeous dress with this huge train, and it's kind of like, you know, from my waist down, kind of tapering down, and just being beautiful and flowing, and just, you know, I had this like grand image in my mind, and I'm standing there in the bathroom, and this dress is just like, and I'm thinking, what have I done? So I went, I think Amazon or eBay, and I bought a petticoat, and it changed my life. Once you put it underneath, you're like, oh wow, this dress has some volume. Wow, this is gorgeous. So definitely think about that. You know, if you want some volume to your dress, you have to think about the support system underneath the skirt, whether it's petticoat or something else. But yeah, think about that. Number one was believing in yourself. Number two, you have to decide why are you doing this. And number three, the biggest thing that you can do for yourself is have a game plan. So my plan was that, you know, this is what I want. This is how much time I have. This is where I'm going to source the fabric. This is, you know, where I'm going to look for the pattern. So I had a very clear vision of what am I doing. Without that, I don't think this project would have been possible, because there's going to be a lot of anxiety down the road of sewing your wedding dress, because it's not just another skirt or another pair of pants. It's your wedding dress. Now, there's one thing that I didn't do and I wish I would have. I didn't go window shopping. So I think with wedding dresses especially, because you don't want to waste the time on creating a silhouette that's not going to fit you or that you're not going to love once you put it on. So you really want to be solid about what is your choice and what are you making. Besides, fabric for wedding dress can also be pretty expensive. It, you know, depends on what you go with, but you also don't want to cut into the fabric just to realize that, oh, you know what, you know, off the shoulder look just really doesn't look good on me, or I'm just really not in love with that. So I wish I would have done that. I am 100% in love with my wedding dress, and I love the way it looked, and I think I was just lucky that I chose the silhouette and the pattern that that really fit me and fit my style. If that would have gone any other way, I think I would have been in trouble. So you also need to have some resources when you're doing such major work as creating your wedding dress. I went with Berta Style, and the pattern was this gorgeous wedding dress pattern, and I did modify it a little bit because the dress itself just wasn't long enough, or the train just wasn't as long as I wanted it to be. So I ended up, you know, cutting it out like a lot larger. And be prepared, you will need to have a lot of floor space, you know, to be able to do that. Also, here's one tip, you know, if you are already living together with your significant other, you will need to kind of play around it, because you don't want him to see the dress while you're making it, especially if you're keeping it as a secret, as a surprise. So you will need to kind of sneak around and make sure that you have the available time to yourself to be able to cut the pattern pieces out and to sew it, because it's a lot of fabric. It really is a lot of fabric, and it's almost impossible to go unnoticed unless you really try to. So yeah, I decided to go with Berta Style, but if to be honest, you can use any summer dress pattern and just make it a lot longer, opt for a really nice long train. It doesn't actually have to be a wedding dress pattern, because a wedding dress is just another dress made in white and a really pretty fabric and some embroidery and that significant meaning behind it. So be creative. Think about it outside of the box. Don't think that, oh, it has to have a title, wedding dress pattern, in order for it to be a wedding dress pattern. I also have one book that really helped me out. It's the Couture Sewing Techniques. I also have a review on this book in one of my videos, and I will link it up right over here, so that or right over here, so that you guys can go and check it out. Be prepared to do a lot of hand sewing on your wedding dress. Of course, depends on how you make it and what is the structure. Maybe it's a really simple silhouette and you won't need to do any hand stitching, but if it is something like this, like I had to do hand stitching on the inside. The sleeves over here are sheer, so I had to do hand stitching to gather them up. I had to attach them by hand over here because the sewing machine just wasn't doing a fine enough job for me. So definitely be prepared to spend some time doing some hand stitching as well. I bought my fabric on eBay, and all in all, this dress cost me, I think, less than $300 to make. So I bought this fabric on eBay, and it's this beautiful burnt out organza. And here's another thing that you need to consider when making your own wedding dress is that you will probably work with materials that you've never worked before, like organza and silk and maybe some satin and some beading and all the other little things that we don't usually wear in everyday life. So yeah, so I bought this fabric on eBay. It's always better to buy more than to buy less. So I do have some leftover fabric from my wedding dress. And what I actually did with that, I made little potpourri sachets for my guests as a wedding favor, and they absolutely loved it. And since our wedding was quite intimate and it wasn't as big, I actually came to each one of my guests and I told them, I said, this potpourri sachet is made with the same fabric that my wedding dress is made, so that way you will always have, you know, a little piece of that day as a memory to remember. So it was really special, it was really significant, it was really significant to me. Another thing that I did, I was absolutely glued to the screen of the TV, and I used to watch the Say Yes to the Dress and Four Weddings for a good like 3 months. I was watching those TV shows because I really wanted to understand what is the wedding dress all about. And although they don't really show any processes, there are a few clips in each of the episodes where they show the tailoring and you know, the veils and stuff like that and the styles of the dresses. So I mean, if you pay close enough attention, it's actually a pretty good resource in understanding, you know, how the wedding dress should look like and what is the tailoring and little things like that. And also they usually show like exquisite things like beading or embroidery on the wedding dresses, so it's something nice to look at as well, to understand if you want to incorporate any of those elements into your own dress. Well, and I think one of the biggest things to not to forget is just to enjoy. And I know it's super hard to do that because if you're tasking yourself with such a intricate job of creating your own wedding dress, it's just like, what? What are you talking about enjoying the time of making this? But yes, try to enjoy, because at the end of the day, it's one of a kind. Nobody else on earth is going to have one like you do. It's your big day, and do as you please. It's your day. Create something beautiful that you're going to be proud of. And always remember that, you know, this dress can go a long way. Like, for example, I'm thinking right now, maybe a couple years down the road, I can create a first communion dress for my baby daughter. Or maybe I can leave it, you know, for her. And I have no illusions. I know that she's not going to wear it to her wedding day. However, you know, she can maybe, you know, have it as something special or incorporate a part of it in her own wedding dress. So you never know. So try to enjoy. Don't make it stressful. Leave yourself plenty of time to finish your wedding dress, and then everything should go as smooth as possible. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you being here. Let me know one more time in the comments below, what is your proudest sewing make up to this date? I would love to read your comments, you know that. And if you wanna see more videos, check out the videos right over here, and I'll see you next time. Create something beautiful, sew up the storm, and talk to you soon. Bye.